Hello, Natercia.
Hello.
Here we are at the number 3 edition of Question and Answer. I have a couple of questions here from João Galrão.
Cool.
So, yeah, these 3 special in mind for you, and the other 4 just to...
Okay,
just for color. Okay, so here we are. The first question João Galrão wanted to ask you is, what is the importance of the string webs in your artistic discourse?
Well, the string webs, I've been handling that issue for a long, long time.
That's why you have this in the first hand. Yeah.
Exactly. And in the beginning, it started with the idea of building something in the space, something that would not be too material, something very ephemeral. So since the last, I don't know, 15 years, I was a lot involved in this idea of trying to create something new, something not too heavy, suspended, and especially that would interact with all the space. And that's also the reason why I started doing site-specific installations, because I wanted to create something that was that would be interacting completely with the space and the viewer. So, and with the evolution and the passaging of time, I realized that it was not only about the notion of the string webs, but also about much more about the notion of my relationship with the space. So in a sense, even when I'm working in drawings, you can find the same lines and the same...
So it evolved to different mediums.
Exactly.
Okay, that leads us to the second question, which is, let me see, how do you see drawing in your strategy as an artist? As an exercise to project sculpture and painting, or as an independent work by itself?
Well, I see it as an independent work by itself, but because I never, when I conceive a site-specific installation or a sculpture, I'm not very worried or concerned about making a drawing. It's something that is very related with the, you know, the process. But I really, indeed, I do drawings every day, or almost every day, so for me it's much more about my action of thinking my work and myself through the paper and the pen, in a sense. So I see it as it's also a way of me to gain some awareness of what I'm doing, or what I'm thinking, or the processes that I'm going through. So it's a very personal relationship, but I see it as a work itself.
So what comes first?
Well, what comes first is the changes in myself. As you know, I do lots of, you know, traveling, and I immerse myself in different contexts so that I can see the changes in my personality or in my way of seeing life and the world. And I think the drawing and the objects that I built are a reflex of that same process.
That reflects.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. So that leads us to the third question. João has the privilege of having studied with you and me too. So we know you personally and your work for a long time. So for the third question, João wanted to ask you is, when did the pharmaceutical universe, with the side of medicine, hospital, and blood, became part of your work?
Well, in a sense, it's not that recent.
It's obviously referring to your latest show, still running on Plataforma Revolver.
Yeah, the morphogenesis.
Morphogenesis.
Well, it's not as recent as that. In fact, when I was still studying at the art school, I was already interested on the human brain and the awareness of our feelings, and I studied a lot the processes of becoming aware of something, the relationship between your inside, your world, and the outside. So I did like a long-term project back then in the 90s related with that notion of perception. But later I came back to this issue, not about perception, but more related with the fact that our body and our abilities as material matter are changing through our lives in terms of our aging and our our performances. And I guess it's also a little bit personal in the sense that, well, in my personal context, there is also a strong connection with my family, my father that was an athlete, and also the fact that he died recently. So in a sense, I think all this medical interest of mine is also a little bit biographical, you know, it's a little bit also about my experience in life, recent experience and all that. But I'm really interested on this issue of the evolution of our bodies. Not in a aesthetical sense, not that I'm worried about the body as a package, but in terms of what we can get more out of our bodies in terms of performing.
Okay, cool. And there's a third question. Well, Joao started to say, what shall I ask, what shall I ask? And then he decided to come up with, what is your favorite time of the day to work?
Oh! Well, I think it's at night, actually, because...
Are you a night animal?
Not that much. The thing is that, as I work every single day here in my studio, that's also my home, I tend to be more relaxed and more serene at night. But if I'm doing an exhibition or arranging a site-specific installation, then I like to work really early in the morning and spend the entire day. I need that time frame of getting early, start doing my work.
You mean routine?
Yeah.
Routine.
Yes, I really need that when I'm installing an exhibition. But during the year and during the process of being just, doing my drawings and my painting, then I'm more serene at night. Yeah, I feel like more...
Awake?
No, it's more like I feel more intimate with
cool.
work.
You
There's
like
more
the
intimacy. Yeah, the silence or the music I like, but it's just me and the space and the work. There's nobody else. So I feel there is more like intimacy. In fact, the exhibition before this one, I was even working on my bedroom, and I felt very good.
I heard about that.
Yes, I felt it was the first time that my work was, I set it up on my bedroom as a studio. I just moved my bed away, and I just felt so good to be just there, like working, and then going back to sleep a little bit, and then if I wanted to wake up, I'll work a little bit
Is
more.
Is it that personal
yes,
work for you?
Yes, I felt like that. So that's also a reason why I have my studio at home. I really like this intimacy. And yeah, I really like
so
that.
So it doesn't care about feng shui that says that?
No, I don't care about feng shui. I just care about being relaxed. I have the materials that I need. I like to have like several materials and then just, just be quiet and start working.
Your show is possible to be seen until?
Oh, until next May. It will be closed on the 3rd of May, so you can see it until the 2nd of May. Yeah, still here in Lisbon at Plataforma de Volta.
Amazing. Yeah. Congratulations on the show.
Thank you.
And thank you for this talk.
Thank you. It was very nice.
Thank you for receiving it. Thank you.
Thank you.